Welcome, Major Pandemians. This is MajorPandemic.com. Thank you very much for watching this video, as well as my other videos on this YouTube channel. I've got a ton of them. And don't forget, I have full-length written reviews on Major Pandemic. So if you're looking for magazine-level reviews and content and pictures with all the gory details, take a look at my site, MajorPandemic.com. I'm also on Twitter and Facebook. So today I want to talk to you about the Infinity Arms No Rest for the Wicked. Now, that's really not the model number, but in the land of Infinity Arms, there are no particular model numbers. Everything is custom. And so we look at 1911s. You really have a couple categories of 1911s. You have the bone stock 1911s. These are the ones that don't have the extended beaver tail. They have the regular hammer on them, the stock gritty trigger, and they shoot 4 to 5 inch groups at 25 yards. $500 to $600 for most places, which you'll find a bone stock in 1911. Now, a lot of companies out there have realized that as people want to upgrade, there's a lot of base parts and extended beaver tail, extended grip safety, extended thumb safety, bobbed hammer, lightened and trigger with some over travel, and maybe a target barrel and some upgraded sights. Those are the basic upgrades, and I think a lot of manufacturers such as Ruger, Smith & Wesson, Springfield Armory, pick one. I mean, there's a ton of them out there. Remington has their new R1 Enhanced. They've done a great job about adding in those initial features to get the customer on the range very quickly without having to do $200 or $300 worth of upgrades and $500 worth of gunsmithing just to get the gun to a level that's competitive with current polymer frame guns. And so with a lot of those guns, you're going to see groups between 2 to 3 inches, 2 to 4 inches, even on the high side, but really in the 2 to 3 inch range pretty regularly at the 25 yards off the rest. Now, a lot of people, hey, I'm craving more. I want to get into competition. I want to shoot faster. I want to shoot more accurately. I want a gun that has a higher capacity. When you get into those types of needs and or wants, as it is with guns, you really need to look in the semi-custom category. Now, semi-custom is really a production line of higher quality guns. And so you really have usually fixed packages. Kimber kind of verges in this category, and Smith & Wesson Custom Shop verges in this category, and obviously STI and some other brands out there are doing a really good job on the, quote, semi-custom. And what you get there is you end up with a high capacity, a lot of times a high capacity, lower frame, custom proprietary frame, custom proprietary upper, availability of other calibers, custom sights, and so forth, that really greatly enhance the overall ergonomics, the shooting, the capacity, the feel, the match grade quality, quote unquote, of the gun. And those guns you're usually going to see are pretty regularly going to shoot under 2-inch groups at 25 yards off of a rest. And then, you know, somebody wants more. And what is the answer if there is no holds barred, you can do anything you want, completely custom, a gun that is completely tailored to your needs? And that's where you get into custom 1911s, and that's where you see Infinity Firearms. Now, Infinity Firearms, Strayer Voigt, is the undisputed top end of 1911s. Just the fit and finish is amazing. Let me give an example. So that is the barrel unlocking out of full battery. That's the slide. There is no sound. It's amazing. So it's kind of like you know, hot butter between two pieces of glass. This is a zero tolerance gun. It's absolutely amazing. There's no wiggle, no wiggle whatsoever between the upper and the lower. All the parts are absolutely impeccably fit. This gun is a work of art from the front end all the way to the back end. They even have their own custom serial number, Reparations 2. Now, the trigger obviously is completely adjustable. This happens to be a 16-ounce trigger. that is amazing. I have a Thompson Center Contender that it has a target trigger on it that doesn't have a trigger this good. It's absolutely stunning. In fact, I was running double taps on this thing and I didn't even realize, certainly realized when it went off, but I was just not prepared initially for the trigger feel on this. It's very, very good. If you're a competition shooter, this is going to be leaps and bounds over anything else you've experienced. And I believe he said, the owner of Infinity said he's done as low as 12 ounce on these. But this one happens to be 16th ounce. Obviously, this is Infinity's own proprietary design where you can swap out different size and length triggers, so you can adjust the overall trigger length as well. The lower is a Infinity Firearms exclusive. Obviously, when you get into the custom category, this is kind of their atypical lower that you'll see. This is high capacity, and what's really nice about this and unusual is this is a 1 1/4 inch width for the grip, and so this gun actually fits my hand like, for instance, the Ruger is a 1 1/2 inch width, total width. This and the Ruger fit my hand about the same. Now, one of the other things that they can do when they obviously get into these custom lowers is do things like do teardrop mag releases. So if you have stumpy little thumbs, you can still dump the magazine and reach the magazine release without changing your grip. That's a big feature, let me tell you. They also have a very oversized thumb safety. This is a 70 series mechanism that they've omitted the grip safety on. So the grip safety is gone on this because that is actually one of the number one reasons there are failure to fires on 1911s. People don't engage that grip safety properly enough, especially in competition where you're concentrated on speed. You really don't want to have to worry about that. And a lot of people have said that's an unnecessary safety anyway on a 1911. What Infinity has done for the competition, competition folks out there, is eliminate this. Now, we'll say the grip is spectacular. See if I can get a close-up of this. This is all 3D machined billet aluminum. And so those little spikes are pretty sharp. And initially, I thought, wow, that's going to be kind of uncomfortable to shoot. However, 500 rounds through this without a glove, no blisters. Quite clearly, ergonomics on this gun and all the little placement of those dots has been thought about long and hard by somebody who obviously shoots a lot and they shoot competition. The sights are custom. The barrel itself is amazing all by itself. It's actually a gold carbonitride coated, titanium carbonitride coated barrel and line barrel that has gained accelerated rifling. So as the bullet travels down, the rifling increases to a faster and faster speed as the bullet travels down the barrel, up to a 1 in 24 twist at the very end of the barrel. What that gives you is a much higher accuracy rate than what you would get out of a static 1 in 8 rifled barrel that didn't accelerate as it went down the barrel. Obviously, the bullet's accelerating, but the rifling is also accelerating. It's going from about a 1 in 10 to 1 in 24 twist. Or I think it's a 1 in 16 to 1 in 24 twist as the bullet travels down the barrel. So you do get very good accuracy. Now, the accuracy I had on this, I've got all the specifics on the full written review on my site, but basically 20-shot 1-inch groups at 10 yards standing unsupported and about 1-point-something inch groups at 25 yards. Really impressive. In fact, I shot a just over a half inch group at 25 yards of a low count, like a five shot group. Take a look at the specifics on that on the site. This thing is the 1-inch gun everybody's been wanting. Now, I will tell you the downsides, and there is a 12-month wait on these guns, and this gun that you're looking at is about $4,000. This is all blued steel. If you want stainless, you're looking at about an extra grand because of the extra fitting and so forth that's required on stainless over blued. The world is your oyster on these things. You choose what options you want. You want compensated, non-compensated. You want a 5-inch, you want a 6-inch, you want a 7-inch. I'm sure they'll make it. And you know, this one happens to be 40 caliber, 6-inch barrel. 20-round, 40-caliber magazines. Obviously, there's even higher capacity, and some that are lower capacity are going to sit flush with the mag funnel. One of the other things I will show you is, just to give you an example of the fit and finish, let's see if I can get the shadowing right, but right here, actually, is the union between the mag funnel and the lower receiver. Usually this is a forgotten part. Even on the semi-custom guns, you're usually not going to see a perfectly matted finish, because this is usually a piece that's not seen. And here you'll see it's absolutely perfect. There's really no difference in feel between the transition from the mag funnel into the actual lower grip frame. Obviously they have the very cool laser cut through or machine cut through infinity symbol there. And if you just kind of look through the details on this gun, every time I pick it up and take a look at it, you just see more and more and more details on the gun. It's absolutely an amazing piece of art that, you know, I think belongs in a box in a wall someplace that you can pull down and shoot every weekend. It's just an absolutely incredible gun. Is it worth the money? Yes. I have shot $50,000 Italian-made shotguns that didn't have a fit and finish at this level. Really, Infinity Arms has taken this to a whole different level. This is art. This is definitely art, and even for those people who are not gun fanatics, they're going to look at this and say, wow, I can't believe that. That's just an amazing, amazing gun. Would I hesitate to own one of these? No. However, unfortunately, this is not my gun. This is actually placed on loan from Infinity Firearms to me for the use of this article, and so unfortunately, it gets to go back. I hope you enjoyed the video. Highly recommend the gun. This thing is amazingly accurate. It provides a level for the competitive shooter, bullseye shooter, and so forth, far above anything else on the market. And I think you would truly enjoy this gun if you are a competitive shooter. Thanks a lot. I appreciate you watching. As always, we'll see you at the range.